Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name is Leigh Fuge and I'm here today with musicteacher.com, and in this lesson we're going to check out five really cool Beatles guitar riffs. All the guitar tones you're hearing in this video are coming from my Stanford Guitars Crossroad Thinline 30. This is a completely hollow P90 loaded guitar, very similar to a Gibson ES330 or an Epiphone Casino, which is heard on many classic Beatles tracks. This is plugged straight into the Line 6 Helix, and I'm running a model of a Vox AC30 amp. Throughout their recording career, the Beatles released many iconic pop and early rock songs, and inside some of those songs are some really cool riffs. We're going to kick this list of five riffs off with the 1966 track Paperback Writer. So this is a really short riff that appears right before the first verse of the track, and it also reprises various times throughout the song. It all takes place in this G power chord position. So starting off on the 3rd fret of the E and the 3rd fret of the A string, before hitting the 5th on the A and the 5th on the D. So for this, you can either play this in one position like a power chord, by adding on an additional finger, or you can position shift. Then we've got some string skipping, so we're back to the 3rd fret, and we're playing the E and the D string on the 3rd fret, before playing the E and the A string on the same fret. Then we're repeating that, but we're sliding up to the 5th. So it's string skip to the D, E to A twice, and the slide on the 2nd time. And then the final note is the 3rd fret on the D. So this is quite a fast-paced riff with that string skipping going on, so here's how it sounds slowly. And now let's take that up to full speed once more. The second riff we're going to check out is an arpeggiated chord riff from the 1969 track I Want You, She's So Heavy from the iconic Abbey Road album. So this riff is in 6/8 time, and it's all arpeggiated chords. So the chords we're using for this riff are going to be D minor. This is usually played with your 1st, 2nd, and 3rd fingers, but for this riff, we're going to play it with our little finger replacing our 3rd finger. Now we need this 3rd finger free for the next part, which is a D minor slash F. So what we're doing here is we're adding this 3rd fret of the D string, which is an F note, into the bass of the chord. Then we're doing this D diminished chord with an E in the bass. This is going to come to a B flat dominant 7. And then we're playing this A augmented chord to finish. So to play this riff, we're arpeggiating each of those chords in 6/8 time. We're starting low, going high, and then working our way back. We're starting with the D minor chord. Then add that F in the bass. Then we're going to that D diminished with the E in the bass, but we're only playing this low to high. We've got this little walk down here, 3rd and 2nd fret on the A string. That walks us down to this B flat dominant 7, which we're playing from the A string down to the G, then the E back to the G. Then we're going to that A augmented chord, playing the open A, followed by the G, B, and E. So So there are some tricky chord changes inside this. Here's that one played slowly. Once more at full speed. The third riff we're going to check out is from the 1965 track Day Tripper. So this riff sounds a lot harder to play than it is. It's quite a busy riff, so you would be forgiven for thinking this is quite tricky. So starting off on the low E string with an open string, followed by the third and fourth frets. Then we're playing the second on the A and D before hitting an open D. So we're rolling up to that second fret on the D and coming off. Then we're assuming a power chord shape. Second on the A, fourth on the D. And then finally, second on the A, open and second on the D. And then we just put that together. So as I said, that one is quite a busy one, but it is easier to play than it sounds. There's quite a lot of notes in there, but take your time with it and start slow if the speed is presenting a problem. I'd also recommend trying to alternate pick that as well, because as you start to build up the speed, it can be quite tricky to play that with all downstrokes. Here's the riff slowly. Once more at full speed. The fourth riff we're going to check out is from the 1969 track Get Back from the Let It Be album. The riff we're going to check out is the chorus riff, and it goes like this. So this riff is made up of two main components. We've got this ascending single note line, 9 on the E, 7, 9 on the A, 7 on the D. Then we've got one of two triad chords. The first one is 9 on the G, 8 on the B, 9 on the E. And the second one is 7 on the G and B, 8 on the E. So here's that played slow. And then once more at full speed. Fifth and final riff we're going to check out is the chorus riff for the track Helter Skelter from the 1968 White Album. This is a great example of when the Beatles did dive into some slightly heavier riffs, and this is a great example of a very early hard rock riff. So this riff is based around a 12-bar blues style shuffle with some descending single note runs between the chord changes. We're starting on an A power chord, so it's the open A string and the second fret of the D, before going to the fourth fret of the D with that open A. Then we're doing the descending run, which is open G, 4-2 open on the D, 4-2 open on the A. What we're then doing is we're shifting everything down a string. So this is going to get lower. We're going to base this now around an E power chord, but still going to go to the fourth fret. The only difference there is you'll notice I hit that second fourth fret note twice. There's that quick little flick on the end. Then we're doing the same descending run, but this time it's starting from the open D string. It's exactly the same form. We're going back to the A then. Then we've got that last little bending figure you saw me do, which sounds slightly dissonant. Playing the fifth fret on the B string and the open high E, which is the same note. What we're doing is we're starting on the and of one, and we're picking and a 2E and a 3E and a 4. So we're picking from the and of one right up to the fourth beat. And as we go, we're slightly bending it. So the first three aren't bent, and then you gradually increase the bend up to the end. You're going to be picking that 11 times in total. So here's how that riff sounds in full, slowly. And then once more at full speed. So there you go, there are five really cool, really fun Beatles guitar riffs. If you want to learn those for yourself, the tabs can be found in a link down below in the description over on the PMT website. If there are any other artists you'd like to see us do these top five riffs videos for, let us know down below in the comments who you guys want to see. Don't forget to check out PMTVUK on YouTube for more free video lessons just like this. And if you're looking for a music teacher in your local area, don't forget to check out musicteacher.com. There's a network of great music teachers all around the country. Thank you so much for watching as always, and I'll see you guys very soon.